Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693ALG442. This is an input output voltage current analog card. Okay, I have one here powered up right now. And just to show you guys a little bit about the wiring diagram before you go ahead and test it, I have an external 24 volt DC power supply, which is connected positive lead to terminal number 1. A negative lead to terminal number 19. I also have 4 jumpers in place. They're located on terminals 2 and 4 for channel 1, 3 and 5, channel 2, 8 and 10, channel 3, and 9 and 11 for channel 4. These are going to be necessary for our current input. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is now that I have a green OK light, power up my power supply. And the user power supply should say OK or have a green light right there. That's the first thing that you want to do if you are doing a troubleshooting test of this unit to see if it's working. Obviously, if the lights aren't on, if it doesn't do its self-diagnostic and come back green like this is, then the card is going to need repair or replacement. Okay. Now a little bit more about what I have in front of you. I have this in an IC693CHS397 rack. You can also use a 391 if you like. I'm using an IC693PWR330 high capacity power supply and an IC693CPU374+ processor. As far as the other external devices that you're going to need in order to do this test, a 4 to 20 milliamp DC generator, which I have, some sort of a voltage DC output generator that can give 0 to 10 volts. For this test, I'm going to use a 3 volt battery, memory battery, with two positive and negative lead going off of it. And then importantly for our outputs, since this is 4 input and 2 outputs, you'll need a multimeter, something that will test voltage DC and milliamp DC. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do once this is all powered up is going to Prophecy Machine Edition. I have a new blank file featuring the items that I just described in my hardware configuration. And slot number 2 is where our ALG442 is, so I'm going to go ahead and right click and add module. Select the analog mixed card, which is the ALG442. Select OK. Now the default values for output voltage or current is 0 to 10 volts DC. Okay, that's both for output and input channels. So we're going to go ahead and stick with that. We're going to click our online offline button to get connected to the processor and then toggle it into online mode. Now at this point, look down below where my arrow is here. We're in programmer mode. The processor is stopped, the outputs and inputs are disabled, and the configuration is not equal. That's because the processor was handling something different before we've asked it to test this 442. So, because that status bar is telling us that, we're going to go to Target, Online Commands, Clear, Controller, and I/O Fault Tables. Okay? That'll keep us from getting hung up when we do a download. So we're going to go to download and start active target. We want to ask to download the hardware configuration and motion and logic. There's no need to write anything to permanent flash memory. So we'll select OK. And then we will enable the outputs. At this point, your processor status down below here again should be run in run mode, inputs and outputs enabled, the configuration and logic equal. If for some reason yours doesn't read the same way, just check over here at your feedback zone and see what type of error it's giving you. And if it's still giving you a tough time, you can go to Target and Diagnostics, and your info viewer screen will turn into a fault table viewer. And it'll tell you if there's any actual problems, okay? So, first thing that we're gonna test briefly here is the analog input side. I'm gonna use the 3 volt battery that I mentioned before to probe my first 4 channels. Input 1 is 4 and 6, negative on 4, positive on 6. Second is 5 and 7, terminals 5 and 7, Okay. Third is 10 and 12. And fourth is 11 and 13. Okay, now, what I've seen so far is good. The first, the three things that I look for is one, that is actually giving me a value. Two, that the values are always the same. If the configuration is the same, the value should always be the same. And not only is the value the same, but the value is stable. It shouldn't be moving around. It should stay firmly at a certain voltage, okay? Next thing is, obviously, we wanna check our output. So we're gonna go to our analog output table. And I'm gonna put in the full value, which in this case is 32,000 on both channels 1 and 2. And this is where we're gonna use our multimeter. I have it set for voltage DC. According to the wiring diagram, the voltage common should be on 18. This is my negative lead. And my voltage 1 is screw number 14. Voltage 2 is 16. So I'm going to place my negative lead on 18 and touch 14 first. And the voltage I'm looking for is as close to 10 volts as possible, 9.97. Channel 2, 9.97. Both giving me a value, both giving me an accurate value, and both giving me a solid value. It's not moving around, so that's good. I would encourage you to divide that 32,000 in half to 16,000 and see if it gives you a reading of 5 volts, okay? Half the value in the address table should read half the value in voltage, 4.9. All right, that's very close to 5, and again, 4.9. Now, you can continue to do this by dividing it in half. A value of 8,000 should yield 2.5 volts, and then 4,000, 1.25, and so on. You can keep doing that if you like. I do it just to make sure that the unit is working properly. But at least get it down to 0, and then recheck that the voltage values have been taken away. All right? So both of these don't have any voltage going to it, and that's exactly what I want. So I'm very sure that the voltage side output is working, the input's working. We're gonna stop it, disable the outputs, go back to our ALG442 tab, and we're gonna double click 4 to 20 milliamp, 4 to 20 milliamp. Same thing with the inputs. We want 4 to 20 milliamp. Now, I'm using 4 to 20 milliamp because I have a 4 to 20 milliamp generator. If you guys have a 0 to 20 milliamp generator or a 20 plus, feel free to use that and select it accordingly. Again, we're going to go to target, online commands, clear any faults that we have before we do a download. Don't forget, we're asking it to do something slightly different here. Download and run. Same thing, hardware configuration in motion and logic. Okay, now, first thing we want to test is our analog inputs. Here's where I occasionally see problems. First of all, going back to these jumpers, you got to have these jumpers in place in order to get an accurate reading. And what I mean by that is, if you don't have the jumpers in place, it will detect that it has a milliamp signal coming in, but it won't be able to decide how much of a value. So when you probe it without the jumpers there, it's going to immediately tell you you have 20 milliamps or 20 milliamps plus. It's not necessarily true. So always make sure you have these jumpers in place when you're doing this. Now I'm going to touch it, and I'm going to reach over to my milliamp generator, and I'm going to go down a little bit, just to make sure that it will read a lower reading than full value. Typically when these fail, that I've seen, they fail at full value, 32,767. So I kind of like to go up and down with all these channels. And it gives me a good feeling that the card is in good working order. If it can read the scaling value that I have going up and down by this dial. So again, I encourage you guys to do the same thing. You can see my value is changing as I change the dial. Okay, good. Same thing, each channel is giving me a value, each channel is giving me an accurate value, and each channel is giving me a stable value. Make sure those three things are working, otherwise there could be a problem with your analog card. And the last thing we're gonna do is, just like the output we did before, we're gonna go to 32,000. For both of these output channels. And I'm gonna switch my multimeter over to now read milliamp, all right? On the left-hand side of the terminal, what you wanna do is place your negative lead on terminal number 19, which is the same terminal that your power supply lead is on, your negative lead. And the two input channels are, channel one is 15, channel two is 17. All right, now, I gave it a value of 32,000 and I have a milliamp reading of 21. And 21 on number two. So we go ahead and I'm gonna divide this in half. 16,000 is the value I'm gonna place. And of course I'm expecting a lower reading, something around 13. So, yep, we have 13. 13. What I'm doing there, what I'm looking for, of course, is a failure, which would be I cut the value in half and it's still giving me that same first reading of 21. Okay, that would be an example of something that's failed, is if no matter what the value you put in, is the reading is always the same and it's always very high. That's what I typically see. And of course, the last thing we want to do is zero this out to make sure it goes down to its minimum value. Bear in mind, however, I chose to do 4 to 20 milliamps, so it's still gonna give me a value, yeah, but the value is gonna be its lowest most. 5, I'm fine with that, that's good, okay? So now, if your card has failed in any of these areas, then that it's a card that needs repair or replacement. And ALG442 is something that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We do exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.